This somewhat complicated Linux command will search every file in my directory and find the one containing the exact wording from today's episode. So how does the find command work in Linux? Well, let's tear this one apart and learn more together. Greetings and welcome to another exciting Little Linux Lesson. I'm Veronica, and today I'm going to cover the basic use of the find command and go into a bit of the lesser known features which make it an indispensable tool. And yes, I can already hear the comments, but Veronica, there are newer, more modern tools to find files on a Linux system. And to a certain extent, I do get it. Not only has find been around for a while, but as always, there are lots of different ways to solve problems in a Linux terminal. But I'm a firm believer in learning the fundamentals, and find is an absolutely fundamental tool in system administration, so that's what I'm teaching here. I'm sure a few of you will disagree with me in the comments, and that's great. I welcome your critique with all of the patience of a substitute 8th grade math teacher. Now, there's a few different variants of find, but you can typically count on the basics working successfully on just about any NICs out there. And it's that portability which makes find a vital tool for any professional or amateur sysadmin, or any nerd wanting to understand the terminal a bit more. Here, I have a directory with a few subdirectories filled with various files. A real disorganized mess, not unlike some of the servers I've been called in to troubleshoot. I'll start by using the cd command to navigate to that directory. Then, I'll show that there's a jumbled mess of files and subdirectories with the ls command. And somewhere in one of these subdirectories, I've saved the script for this video in a file called findscript.txt. Now, to use find to find it, simply type find, then a period to specify searching within the current working directory. Here, I could also pass a specific directory I want to search, if not the current one. Then, use the dash name argument and pass it the file name in quotes. In this case, findscript.txt. It outputs the location of the file. Easy peasy. This works great if you know the exact name of your file, but that's not always the case. Maybe you know the file contains a certain bit of text, but not the name of the file itself. Don't worry, because find has you covered with the -exec or exec option. The -exec option executes a command based on what find finds. And this is extremely useful for anyone working in system administration or development. And in my mind, is the secret sauce which makes find such an invaluable tool. So let's rebuild our find command, but this time, let's pretend we don't know the name of the file we're looking for. Instead of findscript.txt, let's change that to asterisk.txt, asterisk being a wildcard. Running this command shows us thousands of files, too many to read through manually. But we don't have to if we use -exec along with grep, a popular command for finding text inside of a file, and grep's -l option to clean up the output a bit and show just the file path. I'll be covering grep in a future Little Linux lesson, so if that's something you want to see, do the thing that makes the thing tell you when I've published a thing. Now we pass grep the phrase we're looking for in quotes. And in this case, it's the script from today's episode, which at the beginning I said is, and I quote, the one containing the exact wording from today's episode, end quote. Now, outside the quotes, we need to tell grep what to look at. And for that, we use an empty pair of curly brackets here, which is a placeholder for the results of find, as well as a plus symbol to terminate the command. The plus basically means concatenate the results and run the executed command only once. And if that seems confusing, don't worry. I'll be covering it more in depth in a bit. When we run the command, we find our missing file without knowing the name of the file. Okay, now we've got to talk about other parameters you can use with find, and there's loads of other parameters to be used with the find command. Instead of dash name, we can search by dash iname, which is like dash name, but case insensitive. As someone who works with legacy systems, this is super useful because you never know when the file name or extension might be all caps. And at the same time, it can be just as important to be precise with your commands, so don't get in the habit of running everything with case insensitive. Dash type lets you specify a file type, the two most common being F for regular file and D for directory. In our example, we can use dash type F and skip the .txt part. That's useful if the file you're looking for might be an extension you aren't used to or familiar with, or if something's misspelled. This often picks up many more files than I want to work with, though, so I try to specify the extension whenever I know it. Dash user lets you specify a user who owns the file, which is super helpful when trying to troubleshoot broken ownership issues on a shared server. You can also use dash group in the same way, and there's a bunch of useful dash perm options for permissions. Dash size is also useful as a way to find space hogs on your system. One of these days, I'll go into specifics with these examples of advanced usage, but in the meantime, I'll have to carry on, because there's only a few seconds left in this video, and it is a bit of a complex topic. By working with multiple parameters together, you can use the find command to zero in on the files that you're looking for. And the find command is ever present on Linux systems, because Linux is awesome. And so are you.
What?
So let's talk about that plus at the end of the dash exec argument. There's two ways to close the dash exec argument. Plus will concatenate all of the results and send them to one command, whereas backslash semicolon, with the backslash used as a Unix escape, will send a single command for each result found. As a visual example, I'm going to make a text file for each of my monthly channel supporters in the $10 a month Terminal Nerditude tier. Thanks, by the way. Now, when I run find for each regular file in this directory and echo out each result, with the plus, you can see it renders rather quickly, whereas with backslash semicolon, it's taking more time since it's echoing once for each file. This has some advantages and disadvantages depending on the utility you're passing to dash exec. So as always, the man page is your friend. If you're still watching, ask, "Are you keeping up with the Commodore?" in the comments.